Airships, why they are the future of aviation. Did you know that there are only 25 blimps in the entire world? Did you know that there are three types of airships? And did you know that they were used in both world wars? An airship, which most of us think is a type of balloon that holds up a cabin, and it is excessively big, right? Well, airships are not just there to show the public. They are a revolution. Now, let us take a step back into history, look at the mistakes and how we can improve airships for the future of aviation. An airship is a form of lighter-than-air, or LTA, gas, which fills on the top of the envelope, the balloon that carries the gondola. These unique airships usually use a type of gas that is much lighter than our atmosphere's air to be able to rise to the skies. Examples of LTA gases used in airships include helium and hydrogen. The first modern airship was invented by a German man named Ferdinand von Zeppelin, who we also call the father of all airships. Therefore, Zeppelins became an extremely comfortable way of flying. The invention of the airship was a landmark of the 19th century, as it was comparable to flying a cruise ship in the sky. It was also much better than flying on an aircraft in the early 20th century before the 1940s, since it is much calmer with turbulence and shaking. Here is a picture of the Zeppelin. Well, Zeppelins were an innovative idea until an event happened in 1937, which changed everything. On the 6th of May 1937, it marked the crash of the largest aviation project ever known to mankind. The Hindenburg became the largest aircraft ever built, but it had one major flaw: the fuel cells, which was filled with hydrogen, a highly reactive gas. You see, in the 1930s, as the Nazi government came into power, the US stopped supplying the gas to Germany, and therefore Germany was out of luck, as the United States was the biggest supplier of helium at the time. Since trade was banned between two nations, Germany alternatively concocted a plan of using hydrogen instead of helium, as there was not enough of the latter type of gas. Sadly, due to the static electricity buildup inside of the ship, the hydrogen, which is easily flammable, caught on fire, and the whole ship went down in seconds and was set ablaze. This shows the atrocities of hydrogen and as well as the end of the airship industry. From then on, blimps we see of today are filled with helium, since the use of hydrogen was scrapped to prioritize safety. Sadly, Hindenburg did mark an end to the global airship industry. Now, planes are responsible for emitting 2.1% of the global carbon emissions emitted by humans, and 12% of the total carbon emissions in the transport industry, compared with cars, which produce an overwhelmingly 74% of the carbon emissions I mentioned earlier. This figure does not seem like much. However, with trains, we can reduce that to half of a plane, but it is the slowest considering most countries do not have bullet trains yet. Now, this is when airships come into play. The new flying vehicle, the Airlander 10, produced by British airship company Hybrid Air Vehicles. One advantage of the Airlander 10 is that helium is used inside of the airship, as it does not ignite easily, and hence it is extremely safe, showing that us as humans are capable of learning from the past. Additionally, airships, unlike aircraft, require far less infrastructure, as airports are much more expensive and require asphalt or concrete runway for aircraft to take off, a terminal, and a control tower. Moreover, airports require a lot of space to build, and they are usually far away from the city center. For example, Changi Airport in Singapore is far away from the city center. On the other hand, airships also require far less space than aircraft do, and therefore they can be built close to the city center, where there is very limited space. This also saves people a long way to the airport. Another aviation company from the United States, Lockheed Martin, created a new airship that uses a number of propellers to generate lift. to substitute LTA gases, as our planet does not have enough helium for the usage of airships. According to The Guardian, it said that it could bring aviation emissions down to 90% fewer, which would be a remarkable achievement for mankind in the current age of technology. Then comes safety again. The Airlander 10 crashed in 2016. However, it can be resolved with the Civil Aviation Authority, which can confirm whether the aircraft is safe to fly. The helium inside of the envelope is used for the buoyancy effect, which is an aerodynamic lift, and like helicopter thrust, it requires less helium and more powerful engines are used to generate thrust and lift as the airship is flying. One final thing we must consider, other than the shortage of helium, is that airships are awfully expensive. It costs $21 million, or 6 cents per person in the US, to build even one of small scale, and the Airlander 10 is worth $50 million. A suite ticket for passengers is around $90,000 from Svalbard to the North Pole. Finally, we must take into that they can carry very few people and the mass on the airship is limited. There are only 100 seats and passengers available for the Airlander 10, and there is limited mass the helium can carry. A solution for this, we would build a frame for the airship, and as well as adding more engines and propellers to the airship to generate even more lift. Now, the future goal for aviation is substituting the use of blimps. We can generate less carbon emissions through this hybrid machine. In the future, we will even have electric engines that consume less carbon. But for now, hybrid engines will suffice, and having a flying device that is much faster than a car or ship. There's clearly a bright future for aviation ahead, and I hope you all are looking forward to its development as much as I do. Thank you for listening.